This is an autonomous direction-seeking robot built from Meccano and Lego Mindstorms robotic system. So I'll give you a demonstration and then I'll explain how it all works. So I'll put it on the floor. And I need somebody to pick a direction, and somebody just pick the direction to my right. So I'm going to press the button, turn it to the right, and press the button again. I'll explain how it all works in a minute. You'll see I've turned it back again. Now I'm going to set it going. And the first thing it should do is to go and find the direction you just sought, and goes off in that direction. Now I'm going to be a brick wall, and it's got to find its way around me. So it's looking, and it's decided it's going to go to one side, but still looking to get past me. So it's looking to the side, the direction it wants to go, and forward so it doesn't bump into anything. And when it finds a snug gap, which is just now done, it will turn back to the original heading and off it goes until it comes across another obstacle. So I'll just show you that again. Walk in front of it, it's going to look for a gap to get round me, turn to a suitable direction, and then keep looking to find a way around me. Okay, as soon as it's got round me, I'll stop it and then we explain how it works. Yep, and there it goes, back to the original heading again. Okay, so how does it all work? This is Army Meccano from about the 1960s, using the tracked vehicle. It has on board a Lego Mindstorms NXT2 controller, which is the actual robot brain, if you like. It has several sensors on board. This one at the front is a custom sensor. It's for magnetic compass direction finding. So when we first set it going, we pointed to a direction, pressed the button on the computer, and it took a reading between 0 and 360 degrees. That was locked into memory. When I span it round and we started it going, the first thing it wanted to do was to turn to the direction in memory, and then it set off on its course. The next thing it uses is an ultrasonic range finding. So it has a range of about 10 feet or 3 meters, and it's set to look at objects closer than 12 inches or 30 centimeters. At that point it will stop, look in both directions to find the greatest distance that it can move around the object, then it turns that direction, but again turning its sensor to look for that gap, but also looking ahead to make sure it's not going to bump into anything. There are bumper sensors on here, and if it hits one of those, then it will stop, reverse, turn slightly, and then try again. There is a camera on board, which is a wireless webcam. It doesn't play any function in the decision making, but it's good fun at exhibitions and kids absolutely love it. So once again, here are the Lego motors, here are the Meccano track, how the effects on. This is the bumper control on there, a nice large battery that will last several hours, and there we have it, the SMEE Rover 1. NASA, eat your heart out. By the way, SMEE stands for Society of Model and Experimental Engineers, and it just took this year's prize for the experimental models.